Hey Junkies, how are you? I am so glad to be back. Okay, so look, you guys, I want you to hold my fin to the fire, okay? I want to start, this is my goal, so I put it in my little clipboard here for my planner, and I'm going to try and get videos out every Wednesday and every Friday. So today is my starting day. I've just really fine-tuned this, put it on my progressive calendar, and I'm going to attempt to do blog posts Tuesdays and Thursdays and be very, very consistent with that. And especially because my book, okay, you guys, so I have a couple announcements, and then I want to talk to you about soulmates, which you guys know, I know you guys always love the soulmate videos, but so anyway, let me give you a couple of the, I need to look at my notes. So the first one is that my book, The Tale of Mary Maid Scarlet Rose, which is a little children's book, and it's about a mermaid, but I call her Mary Maid because she's little. It's about a mischievous little Mary Maid named Scarlet Rose. Now, I will preface that if you like the books, I don't know if you've ever, I'm going to give you guys the whole story of this and like start creating, you know, a little bit of more dialogue about what the book is about, how the book came about, where my idea came from, and all that kind of good stuff. So I wanted to just tell you that and say that the release date is July 29th. And I'll keep you guys posted on my social media and stuff like that, so you'll know like when you can pre-order the book, how much it is, where I'm going to be, because I'm going to be doing a 13-city book tour, which is going to start in Florida and it's going to end in California, because the premise and the setting is in Carmel, California, so that's ultimately where I'll end up. And so I'm super excited about this. So that'll be the beginning of August, but the release date is July 29th, which is my soulmate and twin flame Jeffrey and I's anniversary. So we will have been married 2 years. So that's a beautiful little gift for us together as a couple, which is really, really cool. So I wanted to tell you that, I can't even get it right, every Wednesday and every Friday for videos, and then Tuesdays and Thursdays will be on my blog, okay? Every day, usually I post on social media, at least I know I do on Instagram, and I'm trying to keep all of the platforms, you know, fully loaded with, you know, just good content, valued content, that, you know, just little inspirational things or things that are happening that's going on with the book and things of that nature. So if you want to follow me on social media, it's Raquel Margaret Carter, which is on Instagram. If you wanted to follow me on my other social media, everything's Raquel M. Carter, except for Instagram, which is Raquel Margaret Carter. And, or you could just go to my blog, which is RaquelCarter.com, and that's all my links for all of my social media outlets, okay? The podcast, the YouTube channel, everything there. So if you like any of this, if you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, if you think that's something that you would want to do, I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel. And I'm just super, super excited about all of this stuff that's happening. Okay, so now that I got that out of the way, and I'm in the process also, I mean, I've got a lot of stuff going on, but I'm in the process of making the soulmate twin flame. It's like an entire little treasure chest. It looks like a Little Mermaid treasure chest, and it's gonna have like PDF little booklet of the focus wheel sheets that you can use, little affirmations, all the different things that I did to attract my soulmate in 2 months. That's what it's gonna be, all collectively in a kit. So comment below or give me a thumbs up if that would be something that you're interested in. And I'm going to be selling them for $111. You'll have like little affirmation cards. You'll have like particular crystals. You'll have, it's a whole little treasure chest of like a lot, everything that I use to manifest my soulmate. And so I figured, you know what? I should just go ahead and sell this in like a kit. And as long as you do this, you will attract your soulmate. Like, there's no doubt in my mind, if you fine-tune this process and do this, you will also attract your soulmate. So, today I wanted to talk to you about, if you desire to attract your relationship, your soulmate twin flame, and you're not, I'm going to go over a couple of things of why maybe you're not. Talk a little bit more about your energy, because as we know, everything is about energy, and sometimes we just aren't aware unless we're actually told or like say, oh, maybe you should look at this, or, you know, it kind of takes some focus wheels a lot of times. I mean, because it was many days that I needed to go and work out some focus wheels. I mean, one day I think I did like 7 focus wheels because I was really super frustrated, and I was just a little overwhelmed. And so a lot of times just writing those things out and understanding where the energy and your vibration is at will really help you to fine tune and figure out where your gap is. You know, because so often we don't understand, we just keep doing the same thing and we don't recognize like, okay, well, I want and I desire this and it's law of attraction. Why aren't I manifesting my soulmate, right? What we're gonna do today is talk about this. Okay, so the first thing I wanna talk about is why, the couple of reasons of why you may not be attracting your soulmate, even though you desire to, okay? So the first reason could be that you feel needy. Like, do you feel like when you think about a relationship or manifesting your soulmate or twin flame, do you feel needy when you're doing that? When you're thinking about it, are you negative? Are you thinking it's sad? It's kind of like depressing. You feel lethargic. You don't feel like it's not fun. It's boring because you haven't manifested your soulmate. Like, do you see other people? Do you see other people in relationships and you're like, ugh, you feel that there's a lack within you. Like, I don't understand why I don't have mine. You know, you may be doing really super well and be super successful in like your family relationships, your career, your business, your school, if you're going to college, your high school, your all these different things. You might be being, you might be super successful, or you feel super successful in those areas, but you're not successful in your love life. And it's not because like you can't have it all, it's because you're lacking something. And we're gonna get to the fine tuning of that, okay? So if you feel all of those things, like I said, do you feel needy? Do you feel like you want someone there because you kind of want them to rescue you? You want them to fill that gap of like how you don't feel complete within? Okay, this could be a big sign, you guys. That is the biggest reason that most people aren't attracting their soulmate. Is because you are feeling a lack. You are wanting this other person to fulfill you in a way that you don't think you can be fulfilled within yourself, right? So that's a huge big red flag right there to the universe, because that's the energy you're putting out. You're putting out that energy to the universe that says, I can't be complete, or I don't love myself completely if I don't have this person to spend my life with or spend time with or enjoy companionship with, right? So when you put that out there, it's a massive lacking, needful feeling, and it's a needful energy. And the universe doesn't hear what we say. The universe only hears what we feel. So because everything is energetic and vibrational, you're putting out a lackful, needful energy. And so you're gonna get exactly what you don't want if you're focused on that so hard, right? Are you wanting your soulmate? This is another reason you might not be attracting your soulmate. Do you feel like that you need them in order to fulfill you? Do you need them in order to like, oh, I need someone to help out with the expenses at the house, you know? Or, oh, I need them because I see other people have relationships and I don't. And so I need a relationship too because I wanna feel like they do. I feel like I'm being left out. So these are all questions, okay? But the biggest question is, I want you to sit and honestly think to yourself, why do you feel like you need this relationship so much? What is it about you that you feel like you need this relationship? And then we can really get to the heart of the matter and understand why. As soon as we figure out the why for it, then we can reverse engineer it and figure out where you're having those gaps. Now, I also offer for $35 an hour, that's really cheap. If you want to ever talk to me one-on-one, like FaceTime or on the telephone, like of a counseling of type of thing, because a lot of times, you know, I can give this, but then you want to, you know, ask me questions back or whatever, and I can kind of give you a more understanding of how that you can really fine-tune these and work through these things, like as a, you know, like a coaching process, okay? I don't normally do that, but I'm willing to do this because I'm so happy and want everyone to have their soulmate. And so if it just takes, you know, 15 minutes or something for you to figure out like, oh, okay, I totally get it now. Now I know what I need to do and I can go off on my own and swim in that direction of finding my soulmate, right? Sometimes we just have that little thing that we just need to unclick because we don't realize what we're actually doing because we're going about it every day and you get comfortable with yourself. You get comfortable with your thoughts and the way that you think about certain things. And so if we can reverse engineer that, which means to go back through and try to figure out like why you're thinking that way or how we need to reincorporate something and get off of a momentum that we've been on maybe for a long time, it will completely help you to readjust, figure out the gap, and move forward. Sometimes it's just a matter of being stuck in a place and you just need someone else to help you unwind that, you know? Like I was saying, like if you feel like there's this sense of you're not enoughness, you know what I'm saying? Like if you feel like I'm not enough because I don't have my twin flame or my soulmate with me or your relationship or whatever, then that is really where we need to get to the core and heart of the matter because that's really what's going on. And so when you're thinking all of these type of thoughts, like I said, I will reiterate that the universe works in conjunction to how you're actually putting out energy. So if you're feeling all of these negative ways, the universe is going to keep giving you more of that because it's a non-inclusive universe we live in, right? So there's never no to anything. So whatever you desire in life, you're always going to get. And so everything that you focus on is what you will get in life. You are the creator of your life. And so if you're focused on all of these different things about needing a soulmate to complete you or fulfill you, you're going to keep getting a lot of that same energy back. It's just a reflection of what you're putting out. That's exactly what you'll get. Do you see what I'm saying? You are noticing that you don't have that particular relationship, right? And so the more that you notice it, the more you pay attention to it, the more of that is not coming to you. And so basically what you need to do is learn to distract yourself, okay? And I know that that's difficult to do, but basically you've already put your soulmate and your twin flame and that desire in your vortex. So the universe, even if you were to never, like you've already put that in there, you know what you want, right? You know you want a soulmate or a twin flame. If you were never to ever think about having a soulmate or a twin flame for the rest of your life, you would still manifest your twin flame and soulmate. And the reason is because that particular desire is in your vortex. So no one can ever take that away. And just because you're not thinking about it doesn't mean you won't have it. Actually, if you were able to distract yourself, which is what we need to work on, you would actually get your soulmate and twin flame quicker than thinking about it all the time. You need to learn to softly distract yourself from the fact that you don't have your twin flame soulmate in your life right now. Now, that takes a little bit of finagling. It really does. You can't just automatically stop and say, I'm never going to think about that. I mean, that's impossible, right? That's impossible for us to do because you're on a momentum now. You've been thinking this way for quite a long time, so you've increased in your momentum of that frequency and that energy of thinking about that lackful state of not having your twin flame soulmate. So that's like trying to stop a locomotive. It's not going to happen. So what you have to do is softly work yourself back out of noticing that you don't have your soulmate and twin flame. And so one of the ways that you can do this is to softly. Now I use focus wheels. That is just exactly what I use. Let me see if I can have one in here because I'm always carrying them around. I'm just always scribbling like this. Can you see this? Now, do you guys know what a focus wheel is? I actually painted some up and I have a PDF form that's on my Etsy shop. And like I said, if you wanna go to Raquel Margaret Carter, that's my Etsy shop. You can buy that PDF and just copy it off and have it forever. Like it's a Little Mermaid or whatever. And it's just a like a diagram or whatnot. And I actually can send you the how to use the, because I'm not sure if that's even on there. I'm not sure if that PDF, if I loaded that one for the instructions of how to do it, because there is a process to it, but I've done, if you want to look on my YouTube channel and just search in the bar under my name, Mermaid Junkie TV, and then search focus wheels, I have several videos that I've done on how to use a focus wheel, and so you could do that if you want to. But anyway, so like I was saying, you have to ease yourself out of it. You have to learn to slowly distract yourself. So what you would do, and using a focus wheel, this is Abraham Hicks' teachings, will help you, this instrument and tool will help you to soften that notion of you not having your soulmate. And so when you can soften that, and you can actually learn to just let it go and not think about it, because you don't have to think about it for it to actually manifest. So many people think that, well, what if I don't talk about it? What if I don't mention it? What if I don't notice it? Will I ever get it? Yes, you will. But the way that you get it is that you have to softly think lovely thoughts about the soulmate and twin flame, and make that a beautiful, happy, joyful notion of when you're thinking about them, okay? Because if you don't, you're just gonna draw negative energy to that, and it will keep them away from you. It's almost like it creates a barrier when you think negatively. Now, you might be thinking about them all the time, or you may not be thinking about them all that much, but when you do think about them, is it negative, or are you thinking lackful and needful and like sad that you don't have your soulmate and twin flame with you? This is really going to be massively influential in you manifesting your soulmate, okay? So just remember that. So I don't know if that helps, but try to go back through that list and remember, like, you want to not pay attention to the fact that you don't have them in your life. And when you are thinking about them, it needs to be happy, fun, joyful things, right? Not negative, like, oh my God, I hate my girlfriend, my best friend, I love her so much, but she has her soulmate with her. Like, you have to be in a happy place, okay? The only time you're ever gonna create this opportunity for you to meet your soulmate and twin flame is being in a happy state of mind. And that is what attracts them, right? And plus, furthermore, do you want to attract someone? If you're thinking negative, 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 you might have met your soulmate or twin flame, but guess what? It's going to be like a war zone, because you're not whole yourself and you're not a happy person. You're going to attract an unhappy person. Because if you're unhappy and you're walking around, You might find somebody, but they're going to be like, you know what I'm saying? So you want to attract beautiful love, happy, exciting things, right? So that's what we need to work on, okay? So I hope this helped you. If you like any of this information, if you want the PDF, if you have any questions about, you know, getting one-on-one, do a little bit of coaching. Like I said, it's $35 an hour, which is a very good, that's half of what I would normally charge. And we could work through that if you don't want to do that, or you could save up and you could swim on over to RaquelCarter.com, sign up for my email. It's called The Current. And when you sign up, I will let you guys know with information about all about my books when blog posts come out. I won't bombard you with negative dumb shit. Like, you can trust Mermaid Secrets, you know, your email. Mermaids keep our secrets in the sand, so you don't ever have to worry about that. But it will keep you updated on, you know, like I said, like all of the fun little affirmations, or when I'm having a product launch, when my book comes out, Twin Flame Soulmate Treasure Chest done. I still don't have a perfect name for that yet. I have some logbook planner pages coming out. I have all kinds of stuff that I'm trying to get out, but it's a process, you know. But anyway, if you were to sign up for The Current, you'll get all of those updates. You'll always keep abreast of knowing what's coming up and what's coming out and what's being released and launched. And it's just a lovely way to stay informed without having to, you know, always swim back to YouTube or whatever. Like, that's my mothership. My blog is my mothership. And so I would love it if you guys would go and sign up there. And like I said, I'm going to try to keep videos coming every Wednesday and Friday. And thank you so much for you guys hanging around. I love you so much. And as always, I'm yours until my next swim. Ciao!